Oppression. When you think of the word, you tend to categorize it into three major groups. You can be discriminated against based on your race, sexual orientation, or gender identity. Well, there's actually a fourth kind of discrimination that you might not have known about. One that is very dear to me, and that everybody in this room has either faced or knows someone who has. And if you don't know somebody who has, my name is Carson Graham, and it has been really nice to meet you all today. It really has. People in my hometown have been overlooked for longer than I can remember. It has been not moving for years. 30147, Lindale, Georgia. Now, Lindale has been stagnant for, like I said, longer than I can remember. The inverse of Newton's first law rings true in the fact that an object that is not in motion will not ever be in motion until something acts on it. And that doesn't happen in Lindale. Imagine being told your whole life that you have no promise, no destiny, no purpose. This is happening to our students now. There are three things that Lindale needs to thrive and succeed. They need the people in power to care, they need the citizens to care, and they need a vision. When I first learned about this problem, it kind of came upon me to try to fix it myself. And that was a lot harder than I had originally expected. And it brought me to a quote by one of my personal heroes, Michelle Obama. In her book, Becoming, she says, "It is one thing to get yourself out of a stuck place. It is another thing entirely to get the place itself unstuck from itself." Now first, the people in power need to care. In 2017, I remember Lindale being awarded a tourism grant to build something to bring tourism into the community. And this was very exciting for me. However, it was not built until over the course of about 2 weeks in 2019. 2 years after that money was originally set aside. And why? Because nobody could be bothered when there's other projects such as in Rome, Cusa, or Merci that are more important. And how do you gauge importance? By the good people that live there? Lindale has the best people I've ever met. Second, the citizens need to care. Like a domino effect, when the people in power don't care, it teaches the citizens that it's not worth caring about. And it shows. These 10 people represent the graduating class of Pepperell High School in 2018. Pepperell is the only Floyd County school system based in Lindale, and that's not off a highway. It's in its own little community. Out of these 10 people, all of them graduated. And that's awesome. Pepperell High School had a 97.5 graduation rate, higher than any other school in Floyd County or Rome City. I got this information from schoolgrades.georgia.gov on March 25th, 2019. And you know what else I learned from that website? Out of these 10 people, do you know how many of them were prepared to go to college? Not him. Not him. Not her. And not her. 60% of these high school graduates were capable of going to college. Not that they just chose to not go, that they couldn't do it. And why? Because they're taught that it doesn't matter. They're taught that the bar is on the floor and the standard isn't even there. Finally, we need a vision. We can't get anywhere if we don't know where we want to be. And for about a year now, I've been trying to bring in an arts district to Lindale because I've learned growing up in the Floyd County school system that if you're not athletically gifted, your chances aren't that great. Their chances are not that great. Now, when I thought about how to fix this solution, I thought about the fact that Lindale isn't that big. There aren't that many big, giant national things to do. But I did think of one, shopping locally. From independentwestand.org, last access on March 29th, 2019, for every $100 you spend when you go to Penny Annie's, when you go to the Dragon Drive-In, when you go to Jim's Tire Store, 60 of those dollars go back into the community, bringing jobs, bringing teachers, and bringing hope to a community that has been forgotten and longer than my parents have been alive. So right now, there's a big push in the media for representation. If you go back to those three main oppressed groups, race, gender, sexual orientation, you learn that when those groups are underrepresented, it teaches them that they're not worth representing. And with that being said, I want to give each of these Pepperell High School students to the judges. This is Story Vernon. This is Trey Wilkerson. And this is Trevor Gonzalez. These are students. that deserve a fair chance at life. Imagine a world where every man, woman, and child has a fair chance to succeed. That doesn't sound like too much to ask for, does it? It sounds like what we've been fighting for since 1964 in the Civil Rights Act, and then 1,000 years before that in Egypt. So, as a citizen, and also as outsiders, Trinity Fielder, Andrea, they also went to Pepperell High School. They are citizens. They know what I'm talking about. As citizens, as outsiders, we need to speak for those who are being spoken over. Thank you.